I'm making this video because I have seen instabilities with Ubuntu 20.04 and kernel 5.4 on my oldest computer. So I will use this situation as an example, but trying a different kernel might also help in other cases. Before we start to work with kernels, we have to make sure that our system will show us the GRUB boot menu, because that is where we will be able to choose different kernels at boot time. So if your system doesn't show the GRUB menu, first do the following. Edit the GRUB defaults file with sudo nano /etc/default/grub. There we have to change GRUB timeout style from hidden to menu and GRUB timeout to a value of 5 or 10 seconds, for example. Then save the file with Ctrl O, confirm the file name with Enter. Exit the editor with Ctrl X. Now we have to generate the GRUB menu again with the command sudo update-grub. Notice that update-grub also scans the system for installed kernels and other bootable operating systems and enters them into the GRUB menu. Kernel install scripts will also do an update-grub, we will see this later. But first, after this step, reboot and check whether the GRUB menu appears at boot time. Now we can take a look at the kernels. When you enter Ubuntu kernel download in your browser, probably the topmost search result will be this here. kernel.ubuntu.com, kernel PPA, mainline. Here I downloaded and installed kernel 4.19.118 a couple of days ago, and this version is stable on my old system. Kernel series 4.19 has long-term support. It's the kernel that is used in Debian 10. Now there have been several new versions added within one day, and I will try to install the newest one. I will first show you how to do everything manually with just a browser and a terminal. Then, later, I will speak about a graphical tool that would make things easier. When we go into the folder of this version, we see a lot of download links. Here we have builds for different architectures. For 64-bit systems, we would use the files from this section, AMD64. Here are 7 files. Let me explain what they are. There are generic kernels and low latency kernels. For most systems, you would use the generic ones, except when you are on Ubuntu Studio, where the low latency kernel is preferred. Look for the following keywords to find the files for the generic kernel. Headers all, headers generic, image generic and modules generic. With this knowledge we can download the right files. I have created a properly named subfolder under downloads with the exact kernel version as the folder name. I strongly recommend that you keep these files in a separate properly named folder, not just directly under downloads. So let's download them. Headers all. Headers generic, image generic, and modules generic. So finding the right files was the difficult part, installing them is easier. Open a terminal in that folder and enter the command sudo dpkg-i for install. asterisk.deb. So we are using a wildcard, the asterisk, for the installation. That's one reason why we need a separate folder for each kernel. When the kernel installs, watch for errors. The 4.19 kernels seem to work fine here, but when I tried different kernel series, some reported DKMS errors. When that happens, then for example, Wi-Fi drivers might not work. Also note that the installation did an update grub automatically because the new kernel needs to show up in the grub menu. Now we can reboot and select this kernel under advanced options in the grub menu. After booting, let's also check with uname-r. Here it is. Now the deinstallation. First, suppose we want to see which kernels are installed on the system. We could search, for example, like this. Apt search linux-image-grep installed. Now we want to see all the packages that belong to this version, so I type apt search linux-grep 4.19.118. I often use the caret symbol at the beginning of the search string because that narrows down the search results to matches that start with that string. This should list the files that relate to that kernel version, but be careful if additional packages are still displayed that you do not accidentally deinstall something else too. Always keep in mind which kernel files we are looking for. Headers all, headers generic, image generic, and modules generic. Now let's deinstall them with sudo apt purge, because purge will do a better cleanup than remove. You can do it with one command with the package names separated by space. Now to the graphical tools. Some years ago there was a tool called Uku, which is no longer maintained as free software. So I found something else, a tool called Ubuntu Mainline Kernel Installer, which is a free fork of the Uku project on GitHub. When you install software from outside, you have to be careful so you don't get malware on your system. I found this article here, which points to this mainline tool, so I hope it's okay. If you trust the developer, you can install it as a PPA by copying and pasting these three lines into your terminal, one after the other. I have installed the mainline tool on my test system. This is how it looks like. By default, it shows only the newest kernel generation, that means the generation 5 kernels. To see the generation 4 kernels, you have to go to Settings and change this here so that previous kernels are also shown. The rest is pretty straightforward. You select a kernel in the list and install it, or you select an installed kernel and purge it. That's it for today. I hope it helped. Bye.